But really, you know, you shouldn't be afraid of witches. They are not always evil. In fact, sometimes they can be very good friends to have on your side. The English witches today will tell you that it was they who raised the tempest that drove off the Spanish Armada.
In 1588, King Philip II of Spain, the richest and most powerful monarch in Europe, decided to go to war against England. He sent a great armada of 140 ships to force England back into the Catholic faith. The armada failed, and the survivors fled around the top of Scotland and down along this west coast of Ireland. But they ran into a hurricane, deemed to be the worst storm ever to hit these islands in 100 years. 25 of the galleons foundered on the rocks.
It just happened to come by chance, you say, in the very nick of time, driving the Don's warships out into the Atlantic, then back to be smashed in pieces on the vicious rocks of the remote and rugged coasts of Ireland and northern Scotland. Not so long ago, the witches will tell you, they were the force that saved England once again. In 1940, they stayed the hand of Hitler, forcing him to hesitate, immobilized, instead of sending the invincible Nazi armies across the narrow waters to smash the English. Or so Dr. Gerald Gardner, a famous anthropologist, says. Britain's defenses were virtually non-existent. Only a miracle could save England now, or magic. Dr. Gardner tells how the witches gathered in a certain secret place in the New Forest. Oh, did I forget to mention that Dr. Gardner is himself a witch? Well, he is, you know. Anyway, the great magic circle was drawn at dead of night, and various secret rituals were performed. The greatest possible concentration of unseen forces were gathered. The witches raised the great cone of power and slowly directed it toward their target. Then they commanded Hitler with these words, "You cannot cross the sea. You cannot come. You cannot come." And he did not come. But why? Dr. Gardner tells us that the witches summoned the mightiest preternatural forces of all. Exactly how it was done is a closely guarded secret of the craft, which the witches call the old religion. But it is common knowledge, which even scientists know, that the great cone of power is an auric emanation, an invisible yet demonstrable cone of force. To gather these most powerful of all unseen forces, the witches used their own life force, and many of them died there in the New Forest when this was done. But don't think Hitler didn't believe in magic. He did indeed. In fact, he was deeply involved in the black arts himself. There was a powerful group of black magicians in Germany called the Thule Society. One of the founder members of this satanic sect also helped to found the Nazi Party. Another close associate of the Führer was General Karl Haushofer, a university professor, an army general, a psychic, and a magician. He was also one of the founders of the Nazi Party, who believed it was their destiny to conquer the world, and that they were to do it with the help of the supernatural powers of darkness with whom they had made contact. Having made this pact, they could only invoke the powers of evil by a magician working through a medium. The magician was Haushofer. The medium they chose was the insane but undeniably psychic Austrian corporal Adolf Hitler. People who knew Hitler recognized this quality in him instantly. Hermann Rauschning, an anti-Nazi politician and writer who fled to America in 1940, wrote that Hitler was possessed by outside forces, demoniacal forces of which he was only temporarily the vehicle. He said that looking at him was like looking at a bizarre face reflecting an unbalanced mind with a disturbing hidden power. In other words, a man possessed of the devil. Hitler was also obsessed with astrology. It is known that his master astrologer, a man named Ernst Kraft, cast his horoscope, and thus they discovered where and when an attack would be most likely to succeed, according to the influence of the cosmic forces. Naturally, every Nazi adventure was an absolute success. Nothing went wrong. At least not until an astrologer named Louis de Wahl went to Winston Churchill and suggested fighting Hitler with his own weapon, astrology. Churchill agreed, and de Wahl was made official astrologer to the British High Command. By casting Hitler's horoscope himself, he got the same information the Germans would base their moves upon, and so knew where and when Hitler would strike. In this way, the astrologer became a master cosmic spy, looking over the Führer's shoulder while he laid his plan. What could be better than to eliminate the Nazis' master astrologer altogether? They turned up a letter written by the good Herr Kraft, which contained certain passages which, taken out of context, seemed to be treasonable criticism of the Nazis, even of Hitler himself. So de Wahl set off for America with this letter. He showed the seemingly incriminating parts to the American newspapers. Headlines across the country screamed the news that Hitler's chief astrologer had dared to criticize the regime. 2 weeks later, the Nazis' great and invaluable seer was thrown into a concentration camp at Buchenwald. From then on, Hitler completely lost his magic touch. He blindly made his greatest blunder. Deliberately, of his own free will, he invaded the vastness of Russia. And like Napoleon before him, he never recovered. The devil-possessed Nazi leader also used his black magicians to harness the unseen powers of darkness, to jam the radar of Allied bombers when they flew over Germany, to lead them astray. Realizing this, the RAF set up their own psychic warfare department, sending out preternatural power waves to battle the German psychic forces as the guns and planes battled on the material level, and to lure the Luftwaffe raiders into traps where they were cut to pieces by the fighters, waiting to pounce on them with the certain knowledge that they would come.